way know if you don't do boop, boop, boop. Okay.
That's the YouTube feed down there.
Okay. All right. Welcome to episode 48 of What the Flix podcast. Okay, so today, I'm Susan Ayres.
I'm Lon Shima.
I'm Patty Smith.
Horizontes.
And there you go.
What's that That's DJ our crew. Voice you keep doing?
I'm putting my resume out there.
Okay. Here's the sound.
In this episode, we are discussing the Eternals, Benedetta, Venom, Let There Be Carnage, and The Last Duel. So I think we're going to begin with the, that would be you.
Me, yes, because I picked the Eternals.
Okay. Eternals, right.
Let's take a look.
Let's take a look.
Please don't let me fall asleep as I have been since I've been watching it.
There it is.
I couldn't stay away.
Does it have sound?
No, not for us.
I don't play anymore.
But for
you,
them.
But you can hear us. Unless you want to cut us.
No, what I mean is they have sound.
Well, this.
That's right.
I can hear everything from Marvel.
It's kind of a...
Yeah, you don't want to get weird.
See, Patty, we're also lying.
So I should shut up. Speak.
So don't pick your nose as well.
Okay, man. We're scratching the crotch.
Oh, they just can't hear us.
They can hear us. Unless you want us to not be
No.
We can discuss a trailer.
We have watched. Unguided.
Trailer tells you.
Unfortunately,
to me,
and seen them accomplish wonders.
There we go.
Okay,
so
Lon's you're blocking his face. Yeah.
So. It was my choice because it was one of the few new movies I happened to go see. So I will say this, directed by, Chloe Zhao. Now, if you don't remember her, she is the Academy Award winning director of Nomadland. So that was a surprise, first of all. Then I have to admit, I told them I was going to read the cast because I thought all 10 of them were actually very good. So you had Gemma Chan playing Cersei, Richard Madden playing Icarus, Kumail Nanjiani playing Kingo, Leah McHugh playing Sprite, Brian Tyree Henry playing Phaistos, Lauren Ridloff playing Makari, Barry Keoghan, I think, or Keoghan, I'm not sure, playing Druig, that's an Irish name, Don Lee playing Gilgamesh, Salma Hayek playing Ajax, and Angelina Jolie playing Thena. I was sort of impressed with all the performances because I thought, considering the way it is, like an Avengers movie, going into it, at least I knew who they were and what their personalities, etc. So nothing had to be set up. Here we're starting from scratch. And for what little time, I thought they all did a pretty good job. I will mention two other performances, though. Kit Harington is in it, playing the love interest of a Cersei at one point. And then Harish Patel, who I thought, for me, he and... what's his name?
The guy?
Kingo character, Kumail Nanjiani, were the comic relief. That's the, as I keep mentioning, I need to laugh during these movies.
Me too.
And I have to admit, I thought both of them were very good. So kudos to them for making it at least an entertaining movie. But the story itself is all about the Eternals are these beings created by the god or a supreme being called Ereshkigal, who they follow devoutly. There, it's sort of almost like a religion. Ajax, played by Salma Hayek, she is more or less the leader. She's given the one who communicates with him. They are sent to Earth because for some reason, Ereshkigal wants them to protect the humans. You don't know why, they're just there, but only from these things called deviants, which apparently are alien beings that come from there and feed off Americans, human beings on Earth. The odd part is that they just have to stick around. At one point, they said, oh, we've gotten rid of all of them, and so now we have to wait. When our mission is over, according to the god, and Salma Hayek is communicating with them, that's when it's like, we can go home. So at one point, she sort of dismisses the group together because she says, you know what, go ahead and live your lives. See what you want to do. Or see. Two of them, at one point, Icarus and Circe get actually married in a ceremony, which is sort of odd because if you see, I say, watch the reactions of everyone in the group. It's very telling. Angelina Jolie's character, Athena, is having some issues, psychological issues. So she and Gilgamesh have to go off because he said he's going to sort of watch over her because he's at least powerful enough to sort of challenge her. Because their superpowers are very odd. They're all sort of, they use the term cosmic energy. So things like Angelina Jolie is a warrior, so she can create all these weapons out of her cosmic energy, the way Gilgamesh can do the fists. He has these fists, and he's supposedly the strongest person of them. Both the like Icarus can shoot rays from his eyes, which is cosmic, and the Kingo character, he can do these blasts from his hands with it. And it's just sort of odd. So you see them battle them, and then they think they're all done. Then at one point, and there you come up to, because you start from basically ancient men to the Babylonian times to our current time. And then a deviant shows up and attacks Circe and Sprite. And it's different from any kind of deviant they've fought. First of all, that they usually go after humans. They were going after the two of them. So they know something's up. Icarus happens to show up and save them. And then they decide, okay, we have to find out what's going on. And I don't want to give away too much of the story because that's sort of part of the fun. Unfortunately for me, I wish it was just more a shorter, to-the-point story, as always. That's always my biggest complaint.
Me too.
But I have to admit, I was really surprised how much I enjoyed this movie, considering it's a Marvel comic movie. I mean, this is not really a Marvel comic movie in a certain way.
Is it Marvel?
Yes. Oddly enough, that's the one thing, doing my research, that Circe actually becomes one of the Avengers at one point. So it's like, oh, interesting that she's picked. Mm-hmm. She is, in my opinion, sort of the main character. I would say her and Icarus, because they really sort of push that love story that the two of them have, but then it sort of ends unexplainably. He just leaves. And then I guess as the movie goes on, in fact, the movie itself is sort of odd because, as I also point out, it's sort of an international cast. You have sort of a Korean person, he's Pakistani, but I'm assuming he's playing an Indian person because Kingo at one point in his life becomes like a Bollywood star.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what makes stuff fun. You know, you have Salma Hayek, Mexican. You have a deaf person even. I mean, this is, and a gay person playing, again, superhero. So this is the one thing that Disney seems to really be opening up to that crowd. Exactly.
Politically correct. Yeah, right. Exactly. Let's have that list.
We will not get canceled.
But I thought it was entertaining enough. I had to admit, I watched it twice. I had to watch a second time because I actually forgot. Actually watching the movie, it's like, oh, we're going to remove the movie. Oh, I can't remember sort of the details of what's involved. So I liked it. I wish the villains were more interesting. That was my only case. But as it gets towards the end, I think a lot is thrown in there to try and explain things. So that's what I sort of admired as once I get to the plot point. But I would say see it. It's entertaining. But I don't think it's going to be up there with the Avengers.
So okay. Good that you put that there.
Miss Patricia, what did you think?
Well, all the negative things Lon said, I definitely agree with. Like, it was gray to me. It was like, one is I hate PC movies. You know what I mean? Also, two is everybody's so well known, I just saw them. Except, funny enough, I really liked Angelina Jolie.
Yeah, she was
Selma Hayek. I just saw Selma Hayek with a weird hat on it. And it was like, what's that movie she was in?
Hey, Frida's got a hat on.
It's like
sometimes, Dusk Till Dawn. It was from Dusk Till Dawn.
You know, for parts like these, you really need to pick the right people. No matter where they're from, wherever. It's a personality type. The comic relief, I agree. They were perfect. Could I remember any of their names? No. Because you know what? Like Marvel movies, and I always go back to the Avengers because Thor, one word, small. I can remember it. You know? Captain America. I need, because when the names are getting too out there, I lose track of who's who. I thought it was way too long. I thought it was like 4 hours. I thought I was watching a 4-hour movie because it didn't have really any highs and lows, and where the highs could have been, they didn't go there. And where the lows could have, it was just gray all over. Mm-hmm. So I got to say, sorry. I disagree with Lon. Don't watch it. It's boring. Sorry, Lon.
That's right.
Okay. Done?
I'm done.
George?
Me. Let's go to Ro. Yes.
What are you?
I enjoy the movie because I was like this kind of movies. Like Marvel, being a fan. I can see how, you know, I print it out and funny enough,
find out what you think.
I ran out of paper, so I'm missing the Eternals one, but I'm gonna wing it. So the I thought it was like, you know, in a bit like Nomad with superheroes. Nomad Land was it?
That's exactly what it was like.
In a way, that's actually very
because the same director was in a Polish house. So
then it made sense.
So I thought it was a good story, but they could have shortened it again. It was just too long. They gave you too much stuff. Mm-hmm. For a team called the Eternals, and we, you know, I thought, you know, Superman can kick all your asses. So, that includes Icarus. So there was a lot of references to DC Comics with that, because one kid goes, like, he looks like Superman. I saw him on TV. He goes, I don't have a cape. And there was another reference to Batman, which got all the fans excited because that would make eventually a DC Marvel crossover where, you know, Superman might be hanging out, you know, fighting Hulk. They did that in the Marvel Comics. They had a crossover, which was big back in the day. So I like the story, but they made it so complicated. They also went in a way that the Eternals taught humanity, like everything we have in the world is because of them. Like they teach somebody how to make tortillas or somebody how to make, you know, the steam engine or they put that in their brains. So, and the movie shows you, they were trying to show too that, you know, the, actually it reminded me of the Madame Curie movie, that they try to show you too that you come up with something and how humanity would always use it for good or evil, for yes. both. They would use it for good and for evil. And then they try to show that in that movie too. There was a scene in the movie about, you know, the atomic bomb that they did in Madame Curie too. It's almost like the same scene. Mm-hmm. So they were trying to make that point. I wouldn't say one of my favorite Marvel movies. I like the characters. I like the Gilgamesh guy. And I like the Kumail Nanjiani guy. And the psychic. The psychic was so funny.
No, exactly.
Yes. He's always trying to make a documentary of their thing. And and they're always, you know, break his camera. And he has another camera right away.
I know. His humility is in that character. He's amazing. He was so amazing.
He really was so great in that film. So, yeah. But yeah, I also, you know, in a way, it is kind of like a almost like a murder mystery too, with a twist.
Yes,
at the end, if you think about
very much so.
It just, I would just cut down the length of it, but I did not. But I enjoyed it. I actually saw it twice. So
okay, actually, the little I would call it the Tinkerbell character.
Sprite.
And oh yes, Sprite.
That was the only two people I really understood was the Peter Pan person.
Oh, when he said that, yeah.
And when he said, there's a little character. What's her name? She can never become an adult.
Yeah, that's Sprite.
Sprite.
The Sprite.
Yeah, the Lisa McHugh.
And he was saying like McHugh. Peter Pan and Tinkerbell there, and I was like, that's exactly what their relationship is.
Yes,
she's
very much
tink
so.
To him. Mm-hmm. It's the only relationship I understood. too many superheroes going on. And it was like I could barely follow the story. It was like
me
just
too.
I was so many stories going on. It was very confusing to me. Yes, they are necessary to fight the deviants.
And I was like,
but so many different.
And
stories.
I was like, you got two Starks in love with a Cersei.
Okay, I could not keep track. I could not keep track. Okay.
Game of Thrones.
Chloe Zhao. Okay, exactly what he said. The cinematography was amazing. It was beautiful to watch. It was like this thick, it was great.
And
like
you were talking about Dune earlier, and it reminded me of Dune was that big too.
Yeah, it's got these really beautiful big shots. But and so props to Ben Davis was the cinematographer.
Yes.
And it was that was great. But other than that, like I said, I'm not a big superhero person. I could not follow the story. There was, but maybe that's because I don't actually know the characters very well. So
there's so many stories in that.
So I couldn't. It melted it down. Yeah, I was just kind of confused the whole time, but it was really pretty going on.
Oh, were you really confused out of curiosity?
Yeah, me too.
Oh my goodness. Okay, that's really interesting.
You couldn't follow the story?
No, because there was too many of them.
Well, see, that I understand it. Like you said, when they do that ensemble. But my thing was, that's why I had to give kudos to the actors, because I thought they really conveyed the sense of what their characters were and what they did. Especially like you were saying about the Druig and the Faceless character. They're the ones who really said, no, why do we have to do this for humanity? We can save them, right?
Yeah.
But then once you find what the purpose of humanity is, it's very interesting. So it's like, because that's why they both say, no, these people should just all die. You know, they don't know how to deal with that. And yet they're the ones who are most compassionate, saying, no, we can actually save these people. And their mission, no, we do not get involved. Only if deviants are involved. In fact, at one point, they bring up the Avengers with the Thanos character, right? How come you didn't battle Thanos? He says, we are instructed not to get involved with humans unless deviants are involved.
Well, see, so I think that it would have been helpful if I would have watched it with you.
But also, I think it has to do with that. This is a whole bunch of new characters or unknown characters, but it's to most people. Mm-hmm. Whereas Avengers... Yeah. Most people know.
I knew nothing about. I never read any of the comic books, but
we somehow. But
every character was very strong in what they did. I didn't feel with the Eternals, anybody stood out.
Like, but even if you didn't read comics, when you watched the Avengers, you heard about Hulk.
No, that's just Captain America.
I never heard of these people.
Well, most people, it kind of goes into the culture, like Lou Ferrigno back in the 70s.
Didn't you watch like Iron Man? I thought you watched.
No.
Oh, so Avengers was literally the first time.
The first thing, and then I watched all of them.
Because I would say most people have, there's certain characters that are famous, like Superman and Batman. Everybody knows who they are.
Okay, even if you don't
follow,
okay.
Even if you don't follow comics.
Right.
This guy's giving you, the Eternals. It's like, they're coming out of like the B-side. So,
right.
So
well, I never even heard of that. That's why I said I never heard of that. That's why
I heard of them, but I did not read those comics because I'm not going into the whole Silver Surfer. And
I don't think any of us are Marvel people. We don't really. But isn't Spider-Man Marvel?
Oh, exactly.
Spider-Man is really the only one I was aware of. So that's an age thing.
I mean, I heard of the Eternals when I was reading some of those, like if I start reading Silver Surfer comics, because that goes into the universe and outer space. But still, I wasn't into them.
They're no X-Men.
What time period did they come out? I mean,
actually, they came out pretty early, actually.
Really?
It must have been.
Okay.
So it's not that, but, there's so many of them. You can only pick the ones you like, basically.
George is exactly like video games, comic books. He was there.
There.
He knows them.
Yep.
He's like, well, that's a Marvel. No, that's a Marvel. Right. I was like, really? Oh, okay.
I didn't even know there was Marvel and DC.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. And that's
Oh, yeah. Oh,
that's sort of the only thing I can say.
In fact, I was going to say, for me, the most exciting part of the movie for me was the post-credits.
Oh, yeah.
Which part?
That was when I heard a Mahershala Ali's voice as Blade talking to the Black Knight, which is Kit Harington.
Right.
And it's like, and I was like, ooh, that's, we're going to see some Blade now.
It's going to be good.
Spoiler.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, shoot.
But no, you're right. See, that's why I actually mentioned Kit Harington, because it's like that he's a very important person.
Oh, shoot, yeah.
But and then even during the credits, in the middle part, before you get to the end, they show, I think, the main credits. Then there's a small little insert as well.
I love that.
Now, my thing was, I didn't know who that was, except the actor. And then I found out it wasn't an actor. It was Harry Styles, who I guess
is the pop singer. The singer.
Okay,
yeah.
See, I don't even know who
that
is.
It's from that band with the British guys, like a boy band. Yeah.
Okay. So I thought, wow, okay, that's another teaser for him.
Oh, yeah. I hate when they put singers in. Okay, Susie, I'm dying to see what Long has to say.
Are we ready to...
We better
yes.
be.
Okay,
Patty.
Oh, I'm sorry, Lon. Nope. 5.
Oh, that's higher than I thought.
I still give it a 7.
I'm with Patty. I give it a 5. But you know what? It wasn't one of the worst ones I've ever seen. I just couldn't follow it. It was really beautiful.
Yeah, I gave it a 5 as well.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And you liked it.
Well, like I said, I thought it was entertaining.
Okay, yeah. I don't like it. I give it a 5.
I know.
You liked it. I'm dying to see what Juan's 10 is.
So speaking of 5, we'll be back in 5.
What's the next one?